When was the last time you said your prayers? The last time I said my prayers was yesterday, right before boarding a flight. How often do you say your prayers? I say my prayers every time I have to do anything that's out of my control, for example, boarding a flight. If I had to choose a vocalist for this track, or any other track for that matter, I mean, my answer would always be Sir Paul McCartney. I am just so in awe of that man's talent. I mean, I don't know how one person is born with so many talents, but yeah, if I get to work with him, I know it'll really be something for me. So yeah, Paul McCartney. Things you must do in a lab. I think number one would have to be experiment, because I mean, musicians have pretty much done each and everything that's possible, like, you know, that's possible for a song or a genre of music for that matter, basically, because everything that you can possibly imagine has been done. So experimentation is definitely something that can lead to, like, you know, sort of newer sounds. So that's something that I highly would like to, like, you know, encourage people to do in a lab. Number two would be compose, because that's the primary reason that, you know, I became a musician, to be able to compose music, and it's the most natural form of expression that I have. So yeah. And number three would be to practice and make mistakes, because it's kind of a scary thought that, you know, it's kind of put you on the back foot when you're practicing, from the fear of knowing that somebody would be hearing your mistakes and, you know, judging you on that. So you tend to not practice those things that you're not good at. So definitely one of the things to do, or the most important things to do, would be to make mistake in order to get better. Three things you cannot do in a lab. Three things you cannot do in a lab would definitely be the things that I just mentioned, because in a lab you would be experimenting with or dissecting dead frogs. So yeah, you wouldn't be able to do the kind of things. Maybe different kind of experiments, but yeah, not the musical kinds that I would want to indulge in. Are you a couch potato yourself? Actually, I'm not a couch potato, luckily, because I do get obsessed with things, and then it's hard for me to, like, you know, kind of find balance. So, and there have been times when I've gotten totally drawn into, like, some TV series, and then I just neglect each and everything that's going on in my life, including work for that matter. And I'm very lucky that I've kind of, you know, come out of that phase. But the last time it happened was with Narcos, and I just ended up, like, you know, wrapping up those two seasons, like, within maybe like a day or two. And it wasn't that long, because luckily Narcos just had two seasons. But had it been as long as Game of Thrones, I would have probably just, like, you know, gone ahead and, like, maybe binge watched it within like a week or something maximum. But yeah, Narcos was the last time that I really got drawn into a show, and like, I just couldn't put it down. It had amazing soundtrack, the background score was amazing, also the performances by all the actors, like, it was just so real, man. I mean, you related to those guys so much more, even though they were like narco terrorists and like some of the most dreaded people in the world. So, which is kind of sad, but yeah, it just shows how impactful the show was. So yeah, that really drew me in. Three things you don't know about God relationship. I don't have one particular guitar that I'm in a relationship with. I tend to keep collecting guitars like most musicians do. But the one thing that I do have in common with all the guitars is that I've gotten a guitar cupboard made. I don't have a proper closet for my clothes, but I do have a cupboard for my guitars, because I like to, like, you know, have them accessible, as opposed to, like, be accessible to me, as opposed to them kept in cases where it kind of gets a little tedious to, like, you know, open the cases all the time. So this cupboard is just like one, like, you know, pull and all the guitars are just lying there, and it just looks so beautiful. So, and secondly, I take really good care of them, like, even though I don't get to play all of them all the time, because mostly when you're on tour you tend to use one guitar for that uniform sound on different systems. But I really make sure that all the guitars are in the best shape possible, the servicing is done very regularly, and I always like, you know, change the strings like as often as possible, never let them rust. And thirdly, like, you know, any ideas that I come up with, like, be it like a string section or like any melody or a piano part for that matter, like 99% of them come from me doodling on the bass guitar. And like, you know, it's just one of those things that I feel so fortunate to have in my life, because like, to be able to kind of create something and, you know, put it onto different sounds, which I'm sure not a lot of people could have done back in the day. But now that we have the MIDI technology and so many other things at our disposal, so I'm just glad that I don't have to, like, kind of learn many more instruments in to be able to compose, you know, the kind of songs that I like to write. So yeah.